Dear children, I am your Brij sir, and today I am going to teach you moral science. Chapter 2, Truth is God. Dear children, this line has very deep meaning. This line tells us that truth is God. I have a question for you. Can you tell me? What is truth? I know you can give your own answer, that telling right or something. But dear children, in this lesson, two things are given. And according to that, we can say, if you are not telling lie, if you are not cheating anybody, and if you are doing the right thing every time when nobody is looking at you, so this can be called truth. All these things are example of truth, definition of truth. Okay, so this lesson tells if you have two good qualities, one thing you are not telling lie, you are not cheating, and second thing, you are doing the right thing always. Either a person is looking at you or not looking, then we can say, if you are doing so, you are a good child. One thing more, children, in this lesson, you are told to listen your inner voice. So today I am going to tell you about inner voice. What is inner voice? Dear children, sometimes you feel when you do something good, your heart tells you, you are a good boy, you are a good girl, you have done very well. And sometimes when you do something wrong, then also your inner voice tells you, you have done wrong thing, you are not good. So you know, you can feel a voice is coming from our heart. From inside our body, that is called inner voice. Okay, children? So, we can say, or we have given another name to our inner voice, but that is conscience. Okay? So, being a good child, you always receive blessings from your elders. And when you pray to God, God will listen to you. And who are good, God loves them. So, you know, we are going to read one story in this lesson. So, the story is God is watching. That means God is looking. So, it is a story of a farmer and his son. The farmer had a son and his name was Gopal. And the farmer's name was Kesav. So, farmer used to say his son, "Son, always keep in mind, God is everywhere." And the second thing, God is watching us all the time. Okay. So what happened? After a long time, once there was a famine, nothing grew in the farmer's field. They had nothing to eat. So the farmer decided to steal the grains from other farmer's field. And he told his son to keep a watch if anybody comes to the field. Then, as soon as the farmer was cutting the grains, his son Gopal told, "Father, someone is there." His father stopped and looked all around, and he saw there was no one. Then he asked his son, "What happened, son? Why are you telling that there is someone? There is no one." Then the son told to the farmer. Son told, "Father, you have told me God is everywhere and God is watching all of us all the time." So, listening his son's voice and his inner voice, he felt ashamed of doing so. Or you can say, he felt ashamed because he was doing the wrong thing. So what happened? He put back the grains and thanked his son for reminding that God is watching and takes care. So what happened? Soon there was a relief given by the king, and food grains were distributed and help was given to all of the poor farmers. So children, this is a very good moral story, and it will help you to adapt this good habit. So dear children, the moral of the story is, always be the good one. Always speak the truth. Always do the right thing every time. This is the moral of the story. So I hope you have enjoyed this story, and I will tell you, apply the good habits in your life and be a good child. Okay, bye.